My name is Tobias, and today I want to do the walk around of our new 1005 ESA SCP series. The PSA 1005 and 1006 SCP series are based on a multi-purpose frame. The frame is wider than the old model and will be used for both models, the 1006 and the 1005. Included in the machines is a 2.2-liter three-cylinder Deutz diesel engine without AdBlue technology. Depending on the local market, there can be other engines fitted. The valves for the hydraulic cylinders and for the S-tube are located behind the cover. The cover is easily removed by unscrewing the bolts in the top and then simply lifting the cover off the machine. It is secured in the bottom with two pins that fit into the cover. The PSA 1005 and 1006 series accompany a small compact control unit for the hydraulic controls, which includes both valves. The valve for the drive cylinders and the valve for the S-tube. In the future, there is planning on fitting the valves with an additional lever for the emergency operation. Due to the compact size of the engine, the space around the water box has increased, which makes it accessible. Directly on the hydraulic pump, you will find a valve for the second pressure lever. When you want to use your BSA with small diameter hoses or mortar hoses, you can limit the maximum concrete pressure to 40 bars by switching this lever. The lever can be secured with a padlock to avoid unauthorized access. The BSAs are now equipped with an electrical controlled volume control. Those two valves control the oil flow, which reduces or increases your output. Behind the valve for the drive cylinders sits our thermosensor. And in the rear of the assembly, you'll find the pressure filter. The back panel is a solid piece right now, but there's plans to halve it so to get easier access for future maintenance work. The PSA 1005 and 1006 series is equipped with the S-tube sensor. This is our grease distributor, and we have an emergency grease zerg attached to it. On the right side of our machine, you'll find your high pressure gauge and you'll find the filter gauge for the pressure filter. The RFID on those machines are located at the back of the hopper wall with easy access to the plugs. Opening the hood, you can have a look at the controller that is mounted in the back of the control cabinet. The control cabinet has the number 687232. The vibrator plug is located on the side at the moment, but on future machines will be included in the rear assembly for an easy access. The controls have the black keyboard, and when we open up the control cabinet, you'll see four main plugs. There is the plug XPU1 for the pump, which includes everything that is attached to the rear of the hopper. When you want to remove the whole core unit, there is a second plug located in the frame, so you can easily unplug the whole electric assembly and remove the core unit. To the right, you'll find three plugs, one XD1 for the engine controls, XPU2 for the pump, and XS1 for the power supply. The magnetic switch distributor is included in plug XD1. The machine can be used with a cable or radio remote control. For which there is a plug on the side of the control cabinet. There is no switch for local or remote control on this machine. The machine detects a plugged-in remote control on its own and will switch the operation mode accordingly. Inside the control cabinet, you'll find three CAN plugs to access each CAN line via the diagnosis connector. The machine tank has an oil tank with an oil level gauge and an oil level sensor. The sensor is only for the warning if the oil level is too low. There is no dynamic measurement of the oil level in the machine. Below the drive cylinders, we'll find three magnetic switches. The magnetic switch distributor sits between the cylinders on top. The cable runs through the wire harness for the engine to the control unit. Behind this black box sits the Deutz controller. The Deutz controller is mounted in the rear. And inside we'll find the fuses. We also find relay K3, which is for the electric fuel pump. If this relay doesn't work, the fuel pump won't work and your pump won't start. The display is also explained in a separate presentation. The remote control for the BSA1005 and 1006 series looks like this. It also includes the black keypad. The remote control plugs in at the control cabinet. As soon as the remote control is plugged in, the machine will automatically switch to remote control operation. It includes the functions emergency stop, resetting the emergency stop, start pumping, increase output, increase RPM. Memory function, reverse pumping, decrease output, decrease RPM. Remote control can be attached to the side of the machine. If you want to store the remote control for travel, you can store it inside the machine and the hood will close over it. During operation, you will normally have your hood closed. There is a hole designed to fit the remote control cable and plug, so you can have access to your remote control with the hood closed. Thank you for your attention. Enjoy your brand new Putzmeister BSA 1005 or 1006.